Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So, as part of our video series, we covered the RA framework implementation, building the RA framework from scratch to understand clear picture of how the RA framework is built and how it works. And so, we covered even the building of our individual workflows as well. When do we choose RA framework? See, we will choose the RA framework by default for any enterprise level automations where we have the iterative processes to implement. And the advantage of RA framework is you just focus on your process which needs to be implemented. And everything, the exception handling and the logging mechanism, everything will be taken care by the RA framework itself. And you may need to do the local exception handling, but at the process level or each state level, it will take care of all the RA framework. Everything will be taken care by the RA framework. So now let us see how we can modify the RA framework for our custom projects. So what are the RA framework we have in place right now is to utilize the orchestrator queues, but here, what we will be doing is like how we can modify this other than the orchestrator queue items. To start with that, like we will be taking this robotic enterprise framework as a process, and we will be creating that process language. We will be giving the process name and description as per our requirement. Once it is created, so we can see all the framework components are available here, and we just need to do our automation. Like, what are the changes we generally do for our automation is like so we won't be touching any tile settings and all which we developed in our previous sessions. And what we will do is we'll use the skill all processes. And we will be using our kill process activity inside this for all the applications we are using in the process. And then we will be using this init all applications where we will be using our login to our applications, which we will be utilizing in our processes. And this is only two things which we need to do as part of the init initialization state. And it is not necessary to touch the get transaction data state if we are working with the orchestrator queues. And in the end process, we will be invoking, like we'll be building our activities like to close the applications, whatever we used in our automation. And in the process transaction state, we will be building our required process where we will be automating our complete process automation. And we will be putting our data validations and all. And we'll be throwing the business rule exceptions in case if the data is not matching. So these are the only things which we need to perform in order to build our process. So there is nothing else we need to work on in case like if you are using RA framework with queues. And in case if you are not using queues, and if we are using some data table or something, like in case like if you want to read the data from a data table, in the first run sequence, we will use the read range activity, and we will assign that whatever the so we will be passing on the file name and the sheet name, and we will be getting the output to transaction data. And which is nothing but our data table variable, which we already have by default. And we can have it for any other, like not only the data table, we can have it for the list, we can have it for the array and whatever the iterable objects we will be having. And if we see, all these we can access the items of the particular object with the help of indexes. So this is the only thing which we are going to do. And so, for example, I'm taking it as a data table, but it can be to list, can be to array. So this is done. And once we get this data table, the other modifications, what we need to do if we are not using Orchestrator Queues. So we'll be going to get transaction data state, and here in the get transaction data workflow, what we need to do is we just need to comment this out for getting the transaction data. Disable this activity. And here, what we can do is we can just have I/O transaction data. Oops. If it is a list, it will be directly count. Okay. It is lesser than or equal to in underscore transaction number. So because we are processing one after the other, if we have a number of rows, the total count should be less than or equal to transaction number. Why we are keeping this less than or equal to is, see, the indexes will start from zero, and the index will, and the number, transaction number will start from one, right? So if I have a count of five rows, I'll be using this transaction for five times, right? I need to loop through five times. So it should be less than or equal to transaction number. Because like I have five rows means like I have five transactions. So for that, we are going for the count. And if we want to get the transaction item, we will be using an assign activity here. And we will be using this out transaction item. And to access this transaction item, because even if you are using a list or array or data table, right, the indexes will be starting from zero. And the transaction number will start from one, which means like we need to get the index of transaction number minus one. So we will be using I/O transaction data dot rows of in transaction number minus one. So there is a validation error. It is saying that the data row cannot be converted to the queue item. That we will rectify it. But here, like for first transaction, the transaction number is one, and we are trying to get the zeroth index row, which is nothing but the first row of the data table. So this is how we will access the transaction data. And because here we are using data row, we will be changing the transaction item data type from queue item to data row. If it is array of string, we will be using string. So whatever the data type inside our transaction data object, that data type we are going to use. So we will be taking the data row here. So now the validation. So we got the data row. Just remove this out transaction item. Now all the validations are gone. And what we will do is we need to get that into the main. In main also, the transaction item is queue type. So we will be changing this to data row. And we'll click on the import arguments. And here we will be just assigning it to transaction type. So now this get transaction data is done. Still we have the validation error because in the exception, right, we have this transaction item and it was previously in a queue item type. That's why we are getting this validation. What we just need to do is we just need to remove this and it will be put on that again. So it will be adjusted to the new transaction item data type. Because we change the data type, so we just need to modify it like by just removing and placing it again. So now all of our get transaction data is done, and now the validation at process transaction. So here in this process.xaml we are getting this transaction item, so we will be changing this type to data row. And now the validation is gone. And here you click on this and you pass on the transaction item variable. And now there is no validation at this place, but here we have a validation. Because in the set transaction status, we will be using activities related to the queue item. So like instead of like going to these activities, let us suppose you doesn't know where we are using. So what I will do is I'll simply change the transaction item data type from queue item to data row. So now I change this transaction item or data type, and now we will get the validation errors. Let us come out of this. We'll open it again. So if I click on here, so by default it was changed to nothing. And if we want to pass on the data type, the transaction item, we can pass, but we are not setting the transaction status to this. So it might not be required. If you think like we will be putting the transaction status for that, we can change it to like we can pass on the transaction item. And let us see if all the validation, no, still we have the validations, which means like in these catch blocks also, we are invoking this. So what we will do is we'll just click on the import and we'll click on OK, because it is not required for me inside this set transaction status. And the system exception as well. I'll click on OK. So all the validations in the main was gone. And in case if you are using the transaction item in the set transaction status, right, we can pass on here as well. In the similar, instead of nothing, we'll be passing on the transaction item. And even then the system exception also will pass on instead of nothing. So it is done now. Main we did everything, and let us do one thing. Let us open and see if there is an validation exception in the set transaction status. So we are not seeing anything, but what we see here we have a validation error. So we need to disable this set transaction status. So whatever is there here, you just need to disable this. It is gone now. And in the business rule exception and system exception, we have it. So what we can do is we can just disable this setting of the transaction status. And in case if you want to set transaction status to any transaction data, we can have this transaction data and transaction item in place, and we can do that. So now we just need to disable this. So now let us see if we have any validations. We don't have any validations. So let us close this and let us come back to the main. So this is our workflow, which is not having any validations. Like let us click on this validate project. It will show us if we have any validation errors. So we don't have any validation errors. So this is how we can modify our RE framework to our custom objects, like to get the transaction data and process it. So by reading data from the Excel and assigning it to DT underscore transaction data, we can start working on like as it is, like how we will be working with the RE framework with the queues. So these are the changes which we need to make in RE framework in order to work our RE framework with custom objects. So even this is also done, and we'll try to process this RE framework workflows. Like we'll build some workflows probably in the next week may release the videos of like implementing array framework with queues and without queues as well. And we will be using the same which we modified here in order to process it. So yeah, so thanks for watching and please subscribe to SkillRP YouTube channel.